ladies and gentlemen, in our ongoing attempt to chronicle who is getting in and who's about to get in, and then ultimately who will leave the Republican clown car, Ted Cruz is, I guess, the first to officially enter into the car. And so he's in the front seat, as it were. And so let's take a moment to get to know Ted Cruz. One of the things I find so intellectually curious about Ted Cruz is his musical choices. Here he is on CBS's morning show explaining why and what and whens. When, I guess. The why, what, and whens of his favorite music.
What's your music?
You know, music is interesting. I grew up listening to classic rock, and I'll tell you sort of an odd story. My music taste changed on 9/11. And it's a very strange, I actually intellectually find this very curious, but on 9/11, I didn't like how rock music responded. And country music collectively, the way they responded, it resonated with me. And I have to say, it just as a gut level, I had an emotional reaction that says, these are my people. And so ever since 2001, I listened to country music, but I'm an odd country music fan because I didn't listen to it prior to 2001.
Now, I hear you on country music.
Oh, I hear you on country music. That's far more American in the response to 9/11.
That it died, it wanted my mother, my brother, my sister, and me to grow up and live happy in the land of the free. Now this nation that I love is falling under attack. A mighty sucker punch came flying in from somewhere in the back.
Somewhere in the back.
We could see clearly through our big black eye. Man, we lit up your world like the 4th of July.
That's right, shock and awe, Ambo!
Sam put your name at the top of his list. And the Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist. And an eagle will fly, and it's gonna be here. When you hear Mother Freedom start ringing her bell, and it'll feel like the whole wide world is raining down on you. All brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue.
There you go. Or, of course, there was this gem, too, that came a little later.
Get to keep them by backing down. They say we don't realize the mess we're getting in. Before you start your preaching, let me ask you this, my friend. Have you forgotten how it felt that day to see your homeland under fire and her people blown away? Have you forgotten when those towers
All right, I'll stop that one because we all know this, right? Now, I guess this is more poppy than country.
Rock fell.
Come on, man.
Freedom in Afghanistan, say goodbye, Taliban. Free elections in Iraq, Saddam Hussein locked up. Some are staying underground, Al-Qaeda now is finding out. America won't turn and run once the fighting has begun. Libya turns over news, Lebanese want freedom too. Syria's forced to leave, don't you know that all this means Bush was right?
You know, I'll tell you something. That is so amazing how wrong he was.
Bush was right. Bush was right.
Democracy is on the way, hitting like a tidal wave. All over the Middle East, dictators walk with shaking knees. Don't know what they're gonna do, their worst nightmare is coming true. They fear the domino effect, they're all wondering who.
Kennedy wrong. Sheehan wrong. France wrong. Sam Miller right.
The
country of France wrong.
Yeah. I could go with that.
You guys, you just don't understand what was going. This is 2006.
So by the way,
that was
just
the Wright brothers.
That was in 2006.
Yeah,
they didn't even have like they were really not savvy with their timing there anymore. Even those country guys
you know
were
what?
Like,
I should say this was uploaded on 2006 by them, but maybe they wrote it. Probably
this group? Who is this?
The Wright Brothers.
The Wright Brothers.
Actually, you know, because even by Toby Keith, I think by that point was like, I think I'm gonna do a collaboration with Willie Nelson.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna get a little less political and talk about my heartbreak.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna go back to watching her drive away in my Suburban.
I think I'm a little bit more oriented towards romance cars.
I said my piece about melting children of phosphorus over there in the Arab lands.
And
now let's get back to
my
heart getting broken by a lady named Patty Sue with strawberry hair.
According to Wikipedia, they did write this song in 2006.
Okay.
That's amazing.
What I do like
is... But also, according to Wikipedia, they didn't watch the news for a year and a half before they wrote it.
I like how it ends. It ends their little career profile, which is like 2 or 3 paragraphs long, ends with, as of 2011, the Wright brothers were no longer producing music.
I'm glad
the Wright
they made
brothers
it that
were,
far.
Right.
Well, we got to save that maybe for upcoming shows, if you know what I mean.
Can we just say really quickly to the Ted Cruz, there you go. He expected classic rock, which sort of by definition is classic, to respond to 9/11. So he wasn't even, he was like, because he said he listened to classic rock, but then he didn't like how rock responded to 9/11. But I'm saying, like, if he was mostly listening to, like, the Beatles and the Doors and the Rolling Stones.
Well, the Moody Blues could have come back and written
something. Yeah, you're
else.
Right.